Ish, yeah, ne? Back in them days, when students were students. Nowadays, students are a foreign species with their own ways of walking and talking. And that's what interests me, the talking part. I want to know, what is the definition of slang? And how has this way of speaking affected the now generation? Am I old school or am I still cool? That's what I want to know. Follow me.
Then we say hola.
You don't? No, we don't. We don't say that.
But I mean, that's what people say.
No, we say awe or whatever.
What is awe?
Hello.
I don't say awe. I say hello. Hello. Hello.
When I talk like this, I don't have to think. I can just say what I want to say.
Yeah, I made. I'm going to sing my meat.
Girls, yellow bones. Yellow bones. We like red bones, yellow bones, you know, yeah. Brownies, yeah.
So, what is the definition of slang?
It's a language form that a lot of people make up their own word.
When you're with different people, you have to speak in a different manner in order to get your message across.
I think it's a body of language that's appropriate to a particular time and place.
And the place is Vosloorus, my hood, the place where I grew up. Now, after being referred to as being ghetto by my Model C classmates, I felt I had to examine this a bit further. So I went to visit a ghetto school.
Model C,
yeah, I know, because I've been called that like a couple of times. It's like, most of the time, it's the type of school you go to. If you go to a white school, then they will classify you as a Model C, and then the way you speak.
Model C, man, it's, I don't know, man, it's middle class.
And Model C is my, this is my first time hearing it.
The National School of the Arts. The last place I spent wearing school uniform. It is also the place where I was referred to as ghetto. Now I'm going back to find out. What was it about me that made me ghetto to them?
If you talk like this and not like it, and you talk like this, yo, then you must know you ghetto.
Ghetto is like Kasi style.
You this other, like, you know, khor. Like you ghetto, man, when you speak.
They're very, like, the characteristics of, if they say ghetto, most of the time is you're very loud. You just say whatever comes to mind. You can swear off the bat. You don't have that whole thing of, oh my gosh, I can't say this word or whatever. You just say whatever comes to mind.
Mabatu ghetto kushutima uphakamisa iflag lasekhaya lakho. Kushutima uhlala uTops vele wenza izinto zaselokishini yabo.
Okay, le ngibona khona ukuba ghetto. It's having that township kind of thingy. Yeah, kahle kahle represent ikasi.
Like you ghetto, man.
I was either ghetto or Model C. But do any of these have anything to do with social status?
Social level and amount of money is not really an issue at the school.
Chalk. Chalk is 20 rand.
I wonder what I have to swag, yabo. Shumanji, it is expensive.
Keep 100 rands.
In fact, you know, people take swag for the wrong thing because they think swag is all about like spending money and all that thing, but swag is like how you carry yourself.
Yeah, well, going to top class schools, things like that.
It's swag, it's swag, it's swag. It's swag, it's swag, it's swag.
Slang became such a big part of my school life that I even found myself speaking it in class. What about now?
On that, children don't differentiate. They simply think it's part of saying or speaking. It's part of their life. They don't differentiate. It's only you, the teacher, that will always say to them, hey, speak properly now. And sometimes they won't even notice what wrong they have made when they use it. Then someone else or you have to again refer specifically to that, what they've said, to say, no, that's wrong. Then that child will know that it is wrong. Otherwise, generally, no, they don't differentiate.
Kube mazopala like amagama amancane kuba ngathi slow kakhulu. So I have to use short words.
This is slang ileza bonke.
Nani
we are B.
Let's say we're laughing out loud. Uzobe luthi LOL.
Lol, laugh out loud.
So yeah, it's like those small little words that just creep in into your like essays and whatever.
The things that are affecting literacy far more are things like Mixit and Facebook, all right, and cell phone, you know, typing and that kind of thing. I don't think slang will ever make that much of an impact because it is so specific to a social situation.
Something you would say in a long sentence that would take forever, and you can just say it in one word. So it's just easier to use slang, and then people will understand.
What I now understand is that I jumped between being called ghetto when I was in the burbs and Model C when I was in the townships, just to be a rebel. But from today onwards, I'm gonna speak plain slang African. And that's the word.
I wonder what part of it is
swag, 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 swag,